Okay. All right, so the first note card is going to say physical change, bike slash properties. And what is the first thing that we have down about that in our notes? Physical change, it only changes in looks or appearance. Looks / appearance. So the first thing you're going to write on the back of your card is, it changes in looks / appearance. Remember, the word appearance is just a higher level word for the word looks. It goes along with that higher level thinking skills. The more you think at higher level, the more you'll start using the higher level words. Okay? The next thing you're going to write down is, does not create a new substance. A physical change does not create a new substance. Physical change does not create a new substance. And then the last thing you're going to write down is, chemical bonds are not formed or broken. Chemical bonds are not formed or broken. Underline not. Keyword. Not. Chemical bonds are not formed or broken. Next card, chemical changes, / reactions. Chemical change, / reaction. On the back, you're going to write, creates a new substance, by breaking down, creates a new substance by breaking down, guys, this should already be in your notes, or making chemical bonds between atoms. So a chemical change or reaction is, it creates a new substance by breaking down or making chemical bonds between atoms. There are 6 clues or indicators that tells you there has been a chemical change. You don't have to have all 6 of them for it to be a chemical change, but there are 6 clues or indicators that let you know there has been some type of chemical change. One of them is fire and or burning, or burning or fire, however you want to put it. The first clue or indicator is burning / fire. Number 2 is temperature change without heating or cooling. Temperature change. This should be going on the back of your chemical change card. You should not be making out a new card. It should be on the back. Number 2 is temperature change without heating or cooling. So an example of that would be what? We did an experiment in the lab that was a good example of that. Yes? Ooblet?
Oh, no.
I don't think it changed temperature, huh?
Baking soda
and vinegar. The baking soda and vinegar. It made the flask cooler, didn't it? Number 3 is explosion. We all know what an explosion is, right? explosion happens, there's more than likely been some type of chemical reaction. Color is the next one. Color goes along good with baking, right? Because when you bake a cake, it changes colors, right? When you fry potatoes to make French fries out of them, like, it changes to a different, more of a golden brownish color, right? Instead of the white like the potato is. Okay, odor. Now you need to know that odor, just because it has an odor to it, doesn't always mean there's been a chemical change. When it says odor, odor can be a good smell or a bad smell. Odor is not just a bad smell. Okay? But some chemical reactions does create an odor. And the last one is bubbles or fizzes. The baking soda and vinegar made little bubbles, and you could hear that kind of a fizzing sound, couldn't you? You kind of hear a when it came together. Once you have that down, new card, write solubility, S-O-L-U, should be in your notes, B-I-L-I-T-Y. If it's not in your notes, I'll spell it for you one more time, S-O-L-U-B-I-L-I-T-Y. On the back, you're going to write, matter has the ability to dissolve. Matter has the ability to dissolve. Matter has the ability to dissolve. Then I want you to write example underneath it, underneath that definition. Right, example, sugar in warm water. Sugar will dissolve in warm water, won't it? All you people that put sugar in your tea, doesn't dissolve very good in cold water though, does it? Okay, so that's a good example of solubility, sugar in warm water. Sugar has the ability to dissolve. The next card is density. Density, D-E-N-S-I-T-Y, density. On the back side, you're going to put mass per unit volume. Mass per unit volume is density. Mass per unit volume. So, a good example of that would be a marble versus a styrofoam ball, right? Which one is more dense? The marble. So, if I put something in water and it sinks, is it more dense or less dense? More dense, yes. If it floats, it's less dense, which also means it's less dense than the water too, right? If it's floating, it's not only less dense than the marble, it's also less dense than the water, or it would not have the ability to float on it. It wouldn't have the buoyancy that it needed. Flammability, I'm not going to make a card out of flammability. Everybody should know that that's something that can burn. It has the ability to burn. It's flammable. It's burnable.
Did you want one? You start with season one. Keep going down.
Thank you. Sorry about that, guys. Okay. So the next one, we're going to write chemical properties. Chemical properties. The next card is chemical properties. It's a property that can only change. It is a property that can only change by changing the identity of the property. Chemical properties. A property that can only change by changing the identity of that property. Example would be wood to ash. Chemical properties. A property that can only be changed by changing the identity of the property. Example, wood to ash. What's another example? Well, some of them are still finished writing. Some of you guys, it's done writing. What's another example? What is something you can do to something and it makes it totally different?
Permanent.
Well, that would be wood to ash, right? Yes, Julie. Huh?
Cooking an egg.
Good example. It goes from the white goes from a iridescent, runny kind of consistency to more of a solid white. Right? Iridescent means clear. You can see through it. Right? Okay. The next word is fire. Yes. Fire. The main thing I want you to know about fire is that it thrives on oxygen. What does that mean? Thrives on oxygen. What did you say? Remember to raise your hand. What did you say?
It lives off of it.
If there's no oxygen, there's no fire, right? That's what it means by thrives on oxygen. Fire thrives on oxygen. You get done with that, your next card is rust. And that is when iron or steel is broken down by oxygen and water. Rust. Iron and steel is broken down by oxygen and water. Science words. This goes underneath on the same card. This is on the same card. Science words for rust is oxidization or oxidizing. Let me spell it. O-X-I-D-A-T-I-O-N. O-X-I-D-A-T-I-O-N. Oxidize is spelt O-X-I-D-I-Z-E. O-X-I-D-I-Z-E. Yes. O-X-I-D-A-T-I-O-N. O-X-I-D-A-T-I-O-N. Next card. Reactivity. Now notice that reactivity and reactance is two different things. Reactivity is the ability of matter to combine chemically with other substances. When we were talking about the periodic table, there was an element on there that doesn't hardly mix with anything or combine with anything. Does anybody remember what it was? Argon, what it was, remember? And he said that it don't like nothing. It don't mix with nothing because it don't like nothing. Anyway, so it does not have a very good ability to combine chemically with other substances, right? It's kind of like water and oil. Don't go together, do they? So they would not be reactivity, would they? If we put them together, there's no reactivity, is there? Does that make sense? Huh?
It's like a water balloon.
Yeah, I mean, you can shake it up, but as soon as you set it down, it immediately, the oil immediately starts to separate from the water. Okay, the next one is reactants. Reactants, R-E-A-C-T-I-O-N-S, reactants. And that is the items used in a chemical reaction to make a new substance. The items used in a chemical reaction to make a new substance. So, what's an example of that? We've had several examples. Anybody? Give me an example of our what reactants are. Yes?
Wood and fire.
Wood and fire. The wood and the fire are both reactants, right? And oxygen. You'd have to have oxygen in there or you wouldn't have fire, right? Yes?
The baking soda and vinegar.
Baking soda and vinegar combined together and equals what?
Heat.
Gas. Yeah. Not heat, gas. They do put off a heat, but it's a cool heat. We're talking about the new substances, right?
Yeah.
Product. Your next card is product. Can you have more than two reactants in a chemical reaction? Yes. Product is the new substances that are made / formed. Product is the new substance that is made / formed from a chemical reaction. Is a new substance that is made / formed from a chemical reaction. Yes, Cadence.
I was asking you to repeat it.
So somebody get, did everybody get that, or I need to say it again? Carter, did you get it? Okay, we just kind of have that dazed look on your face. Like, I'm confused. All right, so what's an example of a product? What did we get when we mixed, Gavin?
The slime is the product.
The slime would be the product.
Mm-hmm.
What's our reactants?
Our reactant.
Uh-huh.
The blood.
And? And there you go. Okay. And that will be all the note cards for today. And then we'll make some more out tomorrow. No, I mean not tomorrow, but Monday. Or Tuesday. Monday next week after we've got taken some more notes. Alright, so now, did we talk about this formula yesterday?
Yeah.
And did we get all the way through that little cartoon?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Alright. So, let's know where I need to go for this class. All right, so the first thing I want you to do is we're going to watch this little video, and you're not going to take notes over it. It's just kind of an interesting thing. But I don't want you writing, drawing, laying down on your desk, talking to your neighbor, or anything else while this is going on. Okay? This is the six most popular reactions that changed our world as we know it today.
Show us the universe's basic building blocks, and biology lets the universe understand itself.
I can't get volume on the TV. But if I turn this, you can hear me.
We have thousands of chemical reactions going on inside us every second.
But it's okay, can y'all? Mike, can you hear?
in labs and workshops and factories and even kitchens that have made humans what we are today. A few chemical technologies have made such an explosive change in how we live that they've altered the very trajectory of humanity. Here's six chemical reactions that change history. Fire was our first foray into chemistry, for better and for worse. Whether it's animal, vegetable, or whatever's in hot pockets, cooking our food that makes it easier to digest. We get more nutrition for a lot less work. But there's a different bit of chemistry that turns food from simple nutrition into something fun to eat. In 1913, a French chemist named Louis-Camille Maillard described the most delicious reaction that I know of. Pretty much everything we cook contains sugars and amino acids, and when they react at high temperatures, the result is, well, hundreds and hundreds of complex flavor compounds. It's what browns grilled hamburgers, puts crispy crust on pizza, the golden edges on French fries. Sorry, I got a little carried away there. Anyway, sure, harnessing fire made food more digestible, but the Maillard reaction made it more fun to eat and to drink. Because really, where would we be without roasted coffee?
Dogs and cats living together, that's hysteria!
They say sticks and stones can break bones, but metal does it better. If your ancestors didn't figure out the chemistry of bronze, they were probably conquered by someone who did. The only pure metals that Earth has any good amount of are copper, gold, silver, and platinum. But unfortunately, they're all either too valuable, too heavy, or too soft to make good pokey sticks with. Beginning 5,000 to 6,000 years ago, people began alloying or mixing copper with elements like tin to make bronze, a step up in hardness and durability from pure copper. It was later replaced by iron in most uses, but bronze was the beginning of humanity's heavy metal stage. You like civilization? I'm a big fan myself, and one reaction above all others made it possible. As the poet John Ciardi put it, fermentation and civilization are inseparable. Our ancestors eventually got tired of chasing dinner and were finally able to put their roots down by putting some roots down. Domesticating plants led to a nice, orderly system where a few people grew enough food for everyone, giving the others free time to explore things like art, advanced government, and even science, or at least what passed for science at the time. But eating raw grain is not our thing. And what good is that harvest if it'll be rotten in a couple weeks? By harnessing fermentation and converting sugars into acids, alcohol, and gas, our ancestors that's alive needs nitrogen in order to build the most basic bits of life, like amino acids and DNA. But for most of life's history, converting nitrogen to biologically useful forms could only be done by bacteria in soil. They pull gas from the air and convert it to building blocks like ammonia and nitrates. That was until 1909, when German chemist Fritz Haber, with the help of a couple friends, figured out how to do it on our own. The Haber-Bosch process converts nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas, two simple ingredients, to make ammonia, which we can then turn into an infinite list of useful stuff. So why is this number one? Fertilizer. For the first time, farmers didn't have to rely on crop rotation or shovel what the family cow provided them to get nitrogen. Inexpensive chemical fertilizers let many people grow abundant food for the first time ever. The world grew so much food, in fact, that the global population has more than quadrupled since this chemical revolution. We make 450 million tons of nitrogen fertilizer this way every year. A full 1 to 2% of all the energy we use goes to this process. But of course, salad bars and cereal aren't the only thing we make with industrial nitrogen. Nitrates are necessary ingredients in making explosives, and the Haber process allowed nations involved in World War I and II to unleash destruction on scales never seen before. But whether it was the battlefield or the breakfast table that really motivated Haber to harness nitrogen from air, one explosion definitely won out over the other, and it's just one delicious bit of chemistry that feeds our brains every day. Now, if you enjoyed these fine reactions, I know we skipped over a lot of important historical
Oh, yay. Even with the cords buffering.
Make homemade bombs, what is one of the main ingredients they use? Fertilizer. The bomb that blew up the Murray building in Oklahoma City. Have y'all ever went there to that museum?
Yes.
It was made out of fertilizer. Masses of amount of fertilizer is what he used in the truck. And the reason is because most fertilizers is really high in nitrogen. Which is one of the main ingredients for bombs, for explosions. We will later this year learn about the nitrogen cycle and how important nitrogen is to us, to our environment, but also how it can be dangerous to us and to our environment. Okay? It's kind of like good and evil fighting against each other. So that was kind of interesting, yes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So that was the most important one. And then bronze, who thought bronze was a natural element? Anybody think bronze was a natural element? It's not. We have to mix two elements to get it. That's the reason you, okay? Did you understand the part about bronze?
Yes.
That's what made our metals, made our weapons stronger, made it to where we could build big tall buildings out of steel and bronze and stuff. Which one did you find the most interesting? Somebody tell me what they thought was the most interesting one or they liked the most. Cadence?
The bombs.
The bombs? The nitrogen with the bombs? What about the fire? Yeah, I mean, if we didn't have fire, food wouldn't be too good, would it? And then fermentation. Ferment. What is something we eat that's been fermented?
Cheese.
Wine has been fermented. There's other things that's been fermented too. a lot of times when you hear fermentation, you think of a plant seed. A seed has to ferment, right? Before it can produce a plant. Okay? All right, now, how much time do we got left? We still got quite a bit of time. We're gonna move back to this other one and look at some of these questions. See if we can answer them. See if I can get the computer to do anything. It says I'm still connected to it.
This tutorial. This one is about chemical reactions and that they either release or absorb energy.
Alright, so we need to put in our notes that chemical reactions either release or absorb energy. And you probably want to put that on your chemical reaction note card too. Chemical reactions either release or absorb energy. Chemical reactions either release or absorbs energy. Combining baking soda and vinegar and decomposing water into hydrogen and oxygen are examples of chemical reaction. Which statement correctly identifies what occurs in a chemical reaction? I don't want you to say the answer out loud. I want you to put what you think it is in the book. A. Matter is neither created or destroyed. B. Energy is neither created or destroyed. C. Matter is converted into energy, or D, energy is transferred from one form to another. Which one of those statements identifies what occurs in a chemical reaction? Write down what you think it is. A, B, C, or D. If you don't know for sure, eliminate the ones you know aren't it. From what we've learned to this point this year, everybody should be able to answer this one. Let's look at everybody put an answer down. If you haven't put an answer down, put an answer down. Alright, so A, there's no way A could be it. And we learned that when we talked about matter, right? That it's never created or destroyed.
So, that's wrong. Energy is either created or destroyed. Energy is not created or destroyed in chemical reactions. Matter is converted into energy. It's never converted into energy. Correct answer is D. Energy together.
How many of you got D?
Good.
If you didn't get D, what did you put? Somebody that did not get D, what did they put? We're working on test taking skills right now, in case you want to know. Somebody, did you get the right answer, Jocelyn? What did you put?
C.
Why did you, what was your logic behind C? Why did you pick that as your answer? You don't know? Okay, guys, so one of the things about test taking skills, and we will work on test taking skills this year and next year. One of the things about test taking skills is when you do pick an answer, you need to have some kind of logic behind it on stuff that you have learned up to that point or that you know in life. Okay? Now, we know that matter just exists, right? We can't create it. We can't destroy it. We can mix it and make something else out of it, or we can change it from one phase to another. But all the matter on earth, we can't make anymore, and we don't destroy it. We should know that from studying matter, yes? Energy, same way. We cannot create or destroy energy. Okay? Matter is converted into energy. When we talked about the three states of matter, did we ever say it went from a solid to energy? Did we ever say it went from a liquid to an energy? No. Now, we never came out and said that matter could not convert into energy, right? But we talked about what our different states could go back and forth from, right? And energy was not one of those. That's what I'm talking about, using your logic, the knowledge you already have. So if you do that, you've eliminated these three, okay? So therefore, this is going to be our answer. Now, we do know that energy is transferred, right? How do we know that? What have we done this year that tells us? I don't know if I've ever specifically said energy is transferred from one form to another. But we know it is, right? What happened when we mixed the baking soda and the vinegar? What happened to the flask? Yes.
It got cold.
It got cold. That was due to an energy transfer. Remember, energy transfer doesn't always have to involve heat. Okay? So the warm energy, when they combine those two, transferred from to a cold energy. All right. Let's look at the next one. Statement is true about the role of energy in all chemical reactions. Read them and see what your answer is. The first one we already know is not it because Miss T wasn't paying attention. I thought she was going to read them all and then go back and check them. Okay, B says all chemical reactions converts matter into energy. C says all chemical reactions either release or absorb energy. D, all chemical reactions either create or destroy energy. Write down what you think your answer is from what we know to this point about chemical reactions. Has everybody got an answer? Mm-hmm. Yes?
Absorb energy. That sounds pretty good. Let's make sure that